Hello everyone, welcome to the Frontend Crash Course. In this section of the course, we're going to build a simple login form using vue.js. To remind, in the previous lecture, we've successfully created a new Vue application, and this is a page generated by the Create Vue tool. There are two links that allow you to navigate between the home page and the about page. You can notice the change of the URL when we click on the link. Let's look at the code to see how it's done in Vue. Basically, you configure the Vue router to tell Vue which component to show for each URL path. Here, when users open the root path, the home Vue component will be shown, but if they visit the about path, the about Vue component will be shown. I'm going to delete this about root since we only need one root for the login form. Normally, Vue components are stored in the components folder. However, for components that are meant to be used with Vue router, their implementation are often placed under the Views folder. As you can see here, we have two Vue files, Home Vue and About Vue. I'm going to delete the About Vue file because we don't use it anymore in the router. Then let's take a look at the Home Vue file. This is a pretty basic component because it doesn't do anything except showing the content of the welcome component. If we follow the link of this component, we can see that it is placed inside the component folder. From the code, we can see that this component displays some information about Vue, such as the documentation and tooling, which we can see on the right-hand side of the page. Now, if I click About, this section will become empty, since we've already deleted the About view. So we should get rid of the link to the About root as well. This link is defined inside the app.vue file, which is the root component of a Vue application. Here, inside the navigation tag, you can find two router links, one pointing to home and the other pointing to about. And that's how you can provide links to allow users navigating between views. For our login page, we're not going to need this feature yet. So I'm going to remove everything inside the header tag and keep only the router view, which is a component that tells Vue router where to render the current route component. This is a place where the home view or about view got rendered when we visit the corresponding route. Now, as we've deleted the content of the header tag, we have to remove the unused import of the hello world and router link component. Alright, let's take a moment to talk about the structure of a Vue component. Basically, it's composed of three main sections. The script section contains JavaScript or TypeScript code. The template section contains tags that look like HTML, which can dynamically render the DOM. And the style section contains a CSS code that defines how the elements should look on the screen. The scoped keyword makes sure that the style we write here only applies to the current component and not globally affects the whole page. And if we have no element to style, we can delete the style section from this component. Now, if I save this file and go back to the browser, we'll see that it has only the content of the home view component. The header section with the view logo and the navigation links is gone. Okay, now that you've understood how Vue router works, let's clean up the code that we don't need and start writing a component from scratch. In the home view component, let's remove the welcome import. And in the template section, let's replace this component with the simple h1 tag, welcome to simple bank. Alright, let's save the file and check the browser. This time, we see the welcome to simple bank message instead of the welcome from Vue. Next, I will delete everything inside the component folder because we're not using them anymore. I will also delete the base.css and logo.svg file in the assets folder. I will, however, keep the main.css file because it contains some basic styles that we can reuse for our website. Note that the CSS written in this file is global, which means they will have effect on all of the components. For example, we can use this green class in our h1 element to make a green header string. If you're new to CSS, remember that a dot character denotes a CSS class. Here we use a class keyword followed by the name of the CSS class. which means the style defined in the green class will be applied to the H1 element. Let's check it on the browser. Oops, we've got an error. No such file or directory base.css. This is because I deleted the base.css file, but forgot to remove this import statement from the main.css file. Alright, now if we go back to the browser, the welcome message will be displayed nicely as a green text. Bravo! You have successfully written a very simple Vue component by yourself. To summarize, the way it works is, in the Vue router, we assign the root path to home Vue component, where we use the H1 tag with the CSS class to display a green welcome message. In the app.vue file, we render the router view, which will display the home view when the root path is visited. Then everything is combined together in the main.ts file, which is the main entry point of the Vue application. Here you can see a new app is created, and we call app.use function to tell Vue that we want to use the Vue router. Finally, we call app.mount function to mount the app to an element. The sharp character here denotes an ID, and its name is app, which we can find in the index.html file. Here we also see the script tag that will load the main.ts file. So that's how a SPA or single page application works. The main.html file will be very simple like this, and the content of the application will be loaded dynamically by JavaScript as the user interacts with it. Okay, so now you have some basic understanding of Vue router and Vue component. In the next lecture, we'll start writing a component for the login form. Thanks a lot for watching and happy learning.